Hey guys, your boy Kervers, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Westerlo career mode, where last time I left off, I finished the league part of the season, and we won the cup final, completing the first of my soon-to-be double. And what makes me so confident must be running through your minds. Well, I think I understand the playoffs now. And I still think they shouldn't be a thing, because basically, I only need to win a few games, and I have won. Basically, the playoffs aren't based on results. Basically, it's like a mini-league of the top six. And
Martin Tyler here with Alan Smith. Hello,
as is, Genk, who finished second overall in this season. It, like, cut the points in half of everybody. You know, or rounded them up. Once cutting them in half, like, I was cut from 87 to 44. And everyone else was cut down as well, severely. And obviously, what they're doing is
Jean-François Gillette.
I don't know, possibly. But
and once your reaction slowed down,
now there's 10 games to play. The position, pretty much. It's like the season. Only there's only now 6 teams in the league. There's 10 games to play, and currently I sit.
The host lineup today. The kind of players that we expect, the kind of performances we expect from the individuals trying to make this formation work.
It can at first glance look cautious, but it just depends on the attitude of the players out there. And once they've got a foothold in this game, they can get a little bit more adventurous.
Here's somewhere. Points ahead. Now,
this is how the visitors will line up today.
If I win this game against Standard Liège, I'll be 18 points ahead. The midfield when with 9 games remaining.
So if they start getting overloaded in the middle of the park, that's
so
an option for this manager.
I only need to win like 4 games to win the league, I guess. If I've worked it out correctly.
At the start of the match.
If I understand the playoffs correctly, I think
Highland.
We'll know for sure when a player scores, but I think they are continuing on the stats.
He's got his tackle
from the league. So Gamvolo will have a chance to reach 50 goals. And these extra 10 games might explain why the record is 41 compared to the Premier League, where it's only 30.
Really strong tackle, and the ball's gone out for a throw. He's coming forward.
Saying that, they only play two more games than what they do in the Premier League.
It's a great start for them.
There's the first goal of the playoffs. 8 minutes in, Alcosta slots it in.
Part of their
now,
way of playing here.
Well, let's see what it says about goal stats.
And they've caught the defense out again.
Yeah, no wonder the goal scorer's going across.
If it is continuing on, then it should add on to what Alcosta already had in the league. And it is continuing on. It's his 10th goal of the season. So yeah, he can reach 50 league goals, and it does count as 50 league goals. Okay. So
the first goal, it's 1-0.
Gamvola is going to get a second bite at the cherry. Or 10 more bites at the cherry, I guess.
And it's going to be his throw here. Highland.
It's one way to do it.
Going to try his luck. The goalkeeper.
Ah, that was pitiful. Why did I put no power into that?
Christensen. Throw in now. Just worried about the rain only, in that it's impairing a bit our visibility of the proceedings out there on the pitch.
Yeah, we're nice and dry up here, but unlike the players, who will be pretty wet after 5 minutes.
Tries the through pass.
Here's Gamvola.
A timely challenge.
Across that! 2-0! Well, and both goals are scored by... Scored? Scored by Elton Alcosta.
The match, we'll see. Two for him on the
things are looking good.
And two very well taken goals.
Knock that into the top of the goal. Net. Or the roof in the net, it's better. Yeah.
Just widen the margin.
11 goals now for Costa.
And here's Cisse. And in he goes with the tackle. Good play from the referee here. That will
I'm not going to let that be ignored. That's going to be a yellow card for sure. Yep.
It's going to be a card. It's going to be a yellow card.
Well, that's the least
Emilson,
thing I've seen out there today so far.
That dude. That dude there. His name sounds Brazilian. Emilson.
Attacking now.
Oh, now I get it right. And my shot hit my own clip, right.
He's got his shot off now. What we've got here is a chance for the home team to do the double over their opponents today, Alan.
Yeah, they made a statement, Martin, didn't they, with that earlier win on away territory, and it was a really good performance.
Could be dangerous. And here's the shot.
Oh, brilliant stuff.
No, hearty mouth.
3-0. Perfect.
Just rewards. It's a goal.
Gamvola scores his 46th goal of the season. And that should finish off Standard of the Age.
Certainly was. And they seek to
before
be
the first half
comfortable lead here.
Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead.
Decimation.
Jack Bell put in.
Domination. And that is what you call the two D's of FIFA, ladies and gentlemen.
Attacking.
Decimate
well.
And dominate.
They'll need to try and get the ball back now. The break is definitely on.
The ball on. May score again. Yes, indeed he will. Oh, it's 4-0 before the break.
Well, scoring in any game is worthy
it's
of celebration.
It's already over.
It is special, and he is feeling that special delight at the moment. Another angle on it here. It's turning out to be a comfortable game, this 4-0.
Now, both Alcosta and Gamvola are both on hat-tricks.
Jack Belfodil. Well, this attack
is almost like
to it.
Reacting as if.
And he's got the ball away from
him. He's just realized he has a chance to still reach 50 goals.
Maybe the cross. A lot of defenders between them and the goal, but they've still got the ball. It was nicely worked until that point when it broke down. Now they've got to try and regain possession. Highland. This could be it.
Up hole.
And shoots! Great start.
Oh, I thought he was going to make it fly. No. Henry keeps it in, but it's bundled to the goalkeeper from the defender to snuff out the danger. And there's the halftime whistle, as if to say, yeah, I think they've suffered enough in this first half. Bit of a mercy.
You don't often get a first half as one-sided as this one. They've been very good, the team that are leading, of course.
To the first half. From the referee there.
That's great defending there, stopping that attack.
Second half still needs to occur. As pointless as it is, it doesn't matter.
Schultz. It's safe to play it back to the goalkeeper. He's good with his feet.
And the header. Here's Henry.
Play on, says the referee.
It was unnecessary.
Throw it to come.
For a Liège throw. Due to on the chair, not through it.
It's Fiore.
I don't know why I have to tell you this. What the fuck was that, dude? That was a strange glitch. Anyone else notice that in the background? Is it Shawn Michael? My in-game avatar was a goalkeeper. I'd be a little worried if my goalkeeper took a fucking walk over to the bench.
In quickly. That's a turnover in play. On the attack here. And the away team want to make a change.
And then he wins the battle. But I lose the ball.
That's a sign of better things.
For all the work Henry put in to get it.
Really strong tackle, and they're going out for a throw.
Another throw, and they're going
to. One of the backup brigade is going to have a chance center stage.
Oh, yes, of course that. Of course that. Oh, that was terrible.
Secure, look a bit safer now.
Yeah, that'll make him feel a little bit better about himself.
Still 20 minutes to go.
Costa.
There's good progress with this attack.
Avoids the challenge. In on goal! Good save from Gillette.
Corner kick coming up. Not rushing it here. Moving from one side to the other.
Alpo!
Oh, well saved!
Oh, and Schultz.
This might be dangerous from the corner.
I'll probably butcher his name. But
not quite good enough so far, Alan.
Look at that.
Herbert said he,
a lack of shots and perhaps reflecting a lack of confidence in this player.
Quick to react to make sure there was no follow attempt from Alpo.
The tackle there is successfully done.
Good challenge by Christensen.
It's going to be a throw.
Stop the attempt, the counter attack in its tracks. Cold.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now. They're here.
Or attempt a pass was a straight. So
coming on for the away team here. And we have 9 remaining minutes.
Gavola gives it to Alpo. 5-0. Alpo decides to get himself in on the act. Complete the absolute traction.
Heroes or zeros, it's a zero against his name here.
Well, he left his post, he's outside.
Penalty could have easily been given for that foul. But I scored a goal, so I think that was the reason it wasn't given. Five goals for Strandberg. He might pass 41 as well.
nil, and the game underway again.
Two players breaking the record. What are the odds of that? Two players passing 40. I would be fucking. I might lose my mind.
Gets his foot in there.
This was a really rare thing, and two guys might do it in the same season on the same team.
Trying to switch on the.
He's only five away from that 40 mark. Four here. If this comes to something. Saved by Gillette. He's trying to make some moments of respect save. Oh, hey then. That should have been 6-0. I turned, I shot, I thought he would direct it in the goal himself. And he needed more direction than I thought he did. That's a real disappointment. And I'll take a comfortable 5-0 win.
Hasn't he? And made the interception. Made it look easy, actually. Ishak Belfodil. Came in with a challenge.
And there is the full-time whistle. Putting Liège out of the misery they've been in for pretty much all the second half after the thrashing they received in the first half.
And they've really looked the real... He's coming forward.
Beautiful. And there you can see the odd table as it stands. I don't really know what to say about it. It's really confusing. All I know is I'm 18 points clear. With 9 games remaining, so... Anderlecht, come into town. Sorry, I'm going to them. Well then, it's payback time, motherfuckers. Genk lost, and Club Brugge, it looks like they lost to Brugge. Yeah, they did. They lost to Bruges, which puts Bruges in second. They're 17 points behind me. But a win will put me 20 points clear. Which will mean I only need to win 2 more games, realistically. Three at the most. I think Bruges are one of my next 2 games. Yeah, because Genk are my 5th game, so in the first set of 5. So, yeah. Genk will be in the next episode with whoever else is there, I don't know. I think it might be the team that I played in the last game of the season? In my last game, I think that's who it is.
Hi there again, everybody. Martin Tyler along with Alan Smith for your commentary.
That's not here nor there. I'm going to focus on giving Anderlecht a right thrash.
Across the surface. I did used to like these kind of conditions because you can make 2 mistakes.
Gambola can give Anderlecht a preview of what they can expect.
Anderlecht are going to line up.
because
the kind of players that we expect, the kind of performance we expect from individuals trying to make this formation. And he could get away here
from the star next season.
And now the shot! What a fine save! And the decision is a corner.
A little confused as to why I mean by that. In real life, Anderlecht apparently signed Gamvola, but they loaned him back to Westerlo before to complete the season and see out the season.
Shots on here. Good block. There's the ball in. And here's the shot. And the referee points for goal kick. God. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. Well, the ref's going to let play go on here. It's an advantage. Oh, he's beaten his marker.
Put some pressure on.
The name of the game at the moment.
Rantovic. Cross comes in and it's easily dealt from Highland.
Well, good work from the referee. Play on. There's an advantage. A low scoring side, the lowest scoring team in the division actually, and they've got to try and get the better of the best defence. It's going to be very hard for them to do that, but we wait and see with a fair amount of anticipation.
That's a good time to...
He can put them in front. Oh, well saved.
Wait, how are Anderlecht the lowest scoring team?
And the cross comes in now. Goes
for it. It's Standard Liège. They didn't score any goals. Now, maybe it's including the goals...
And it goes the cross.
Scored and... can see it in the league.
He's kept it out.
It's
gone for a corner.
Stats, but if it's counting just the playoffs, but then yeah, Standard Liège scored absolutely no goals.
Opportunity here.
Oh, Henry!
Although that shot could have changed.
Was shown down to like what they missed because in learning that they are the parent club of Gamvola, I learned that before they signed Gamvola, they tried to sign Henry. But they couldn't agree a fee with Henry's real-life club, the club I signed him from. Which confused me because I only paid 4.5 million.
And here comes the counter-attack.
And to be honest, I probably could have gotten
the goal, and it's put them into the lead. He looked the goalkeeper in the eyes and said, right, I've got the ball here, and he's got the goal to show that.
I love that kind of finish when you don't have to blast it as long as the placement is right.
Great finish, by the way. From Alpo. This is a 36th goal of the season.
Interesting to see what footwear the teams are going to actually use today. Now that the summer rain is coming,
Yeah, and I think sometimes with the lads wearing blades these days, you do see them slipping a bit more, and it might mean they have to change halfway through this match.
Good forward play from them. Tackle here,
Henry. I was trying to get the ball with Gampola. It was there for the taking, but I didn't take it.
The ref blows for the free kick. And that will clear the danger.
Bam.
Here's a chance to attack. This
might be it. Off the post. Elpo. Oh, with the rebound. Oh my god, Costa and Mo. That's good. He puts me 2-0 up.
And he took it.
There's not going to be time for a second brace to put me 4-0 up before the halftime break.
That's
right on the stroke of halftime.
Fourth official has indicated 3 more minutes. On the attack here. Crisp defending there.
Which will give me a nice lead going into the second half. Because the goalkeeper wants to kick it out anytime soon. Nope, he's going to keep a hold of it until halftime. Yeah, it is the team I face at the end of the season. Zulte Waregem. As the other team. So that's who the other game is against. They are either my next game, or they'll be the game I play, or they're my fourth game. I think they might be my fourth game. I don't have any
tackle here. That's great defending there, stopping that attack.
Certainty about that, though. There's Henry.
Slipped his man. The shot's on.
He'll have another go. Off the line. Oh!
It's the wrong side of the post, but only just.
My right back. I found himself in a glorious position, and he missed.
Well, the manager's now making a double change. Goes in.
Alpo.
This could be a chance.
This is the chance for the hat trick. Will he get it? No.
Could have been a hat trick for him there, and he probably deserves one too.
We defense.
I want him to try and get his hat trick.
Finishing well.
Because he's very low stamina. Alright now. Oh, and really, he should be taken off before he hurts himself. Muscle injury.
Came in with a challenge. It's a quick break.
Gamboa. Oh, it's a penalty.
No question. He's given the penalty, and it's all going wrong at the moment.
Yeah, I don't know what the referee is giving the penalty for. Something on Gamboa. He was jumping in the air. Your man just happened to run into an airborne Gamboa. Sorry, DMs. I'm going to give this to Strandberg. I should really give it to him because he's on the hat trick. Big chance. There it is. And that means I can instantly sub him off for Romenz. And get him off before he hurts himself. But the hat trick is complete. You can't get much better than that.
3 goals now.
He's been a thorn in the side of the opposition all match, and he thoroughly deserves that hat trick.
38 goals now in the league. 2 away from 40. Unbelievable. Like, it was only last FIFA when the first person in Cristiano Ronaldo was able to become the first person
substituted. He certainly made an impact on the game with
in
that
the 40 plus category. And
really accomplished penalty that to find the bottom right hand corner. It takes some confidence.
By early March, we could have four players in that group. We already have three, with Mane and Gvara both joining since. And
that's given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway.
The next time I record next week, Alpo only needs to score two more goals in the remaining.
Comes in with a tackle.
Eight playoff game.
It's got a bit of menace to it.
To reach.
Here's a chance. He's kept it out.
That. At a 40.
A corner.
Milestone.
Goalkeeper can get the ball here for his goal kick.
I was really hoping that corner would come to something. All right. Sorry if I went a bit quiet there for a second. I was taking a drink of water.
Makes a challenge here.
Gotta keep hydrated, you know what I mean? Henry.
And he could get away here.
Opportunity. He made four. Back-to-back trouncings.
Corner to be taken.
Unlikely, but not impossible.
So we're coming down now towards the last 15 minutes.
Well, I guess considering who you asked, 3-0 could be considered.
And he heads it for Johnson.
Goal. Oh, man, that's the second good opportunity he's missed in this video. He should have made.
Now he's got the ball. What's he going to do with
it? Six against Stanley Liège. And there he hits the crossbar with
on the
his
attack
header.
Here. Challenges for the ball.
Rather than making it 4-0. Here he gets Anderlecht.
Well, the home team has been outplayed, and the home supporters have lost their will to support, I think.
Well, haven't they just? You could hear a pin drop here. I've seen one or two heading for the exit.
He might be through.
Romance. Can he make it 4-0? Good save from the Anderlecht keeper.
They line up for the corner. Great challenge.
Romance.
The shot gets blocked.
Looks like it's, you lost your flags over here. That's the second glitch in this episode. What the hell? Freaking linesman waving his flag.
He's still
missing it. Pick up your flag, you fucking dickhead.
Shots on here.
Hey! There's a goal for Gamboa. Giving a Anderlecht a sneak preview of what they are hoping to get.
Replay confirming for us here that the goalkeeper did get a touch, but not strong enough to keep the ball out of his net.
Well, he is his own.
I think that's 38 goals.
This lad.
Sorry, 48 goals. I think that is.
Got a touch.
That's 3 in 2 games. You got 2 against Stanley Liège, and that's. Third now against. Yeah, it is. 48 goals. So he's 2 away from 50, and Strandberg is 2 away from 40. Who writes this stuff?
Well, the referee.
Answer is no one.
The
And this is completely off the script.
For some time, in truth. The final score, 4-0.
Sternberg celebrates his hat trick. And I take one step closer to winning the Pro League. Not much else to be said, really. I will, before I end the episode, I will just verify in what order. Okay. Graham, or however you pronounce their name. They are my third game of the playoffs, so Genk, that will put Bruges as my fourth game, which possibility I could have it won before I even play them, which, you know, would be a bit of a anticlimax. The way I could is if I beat Wargram and Bruges do not pick up a win over whoever they're playing, which is, it's not going to tell me. They are playing Liège. Oh, they're playing Liège the same day I play Wargram. Ooh, the next episode is going to be a big one. More than likely, I'm going to win the playoffs with five or six games to spare, depending on when I... Six or seven games to spare, depending on when I win it. Will I win it after the first game? Or will I win it after the second? I'll definitely win it after the second. But will I win it after the first? You'll have to wait and see. Thanks for watching this episode. Subscribe so you don't miss that next episode. If you are new to this channel, hit that little bell so you know when that video goes live. I hope you enjoyed this video. Who hit the like button if you did? Hit subscribe if you are new to this channel. I'm repeating myself, so I'll just say I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.